16-10. They open up actually with four wide receivers. They use as many as seven different wide receivers in the football game. Kustak keeping it himself. Kustak on the game, a pickup of six on the play. The offensive line. Get used to the no huddle for Northwestern. They'll do it 99% of the time. Here's Kustak moving to his left, throwing right and completing the pass. He's able to hook up there on the... Dave Whitvo is our referee today. There is Joe Tiller. Never lost against Northwestern. Going to keep that record alive.
A little different story, though, today. A ranked team on the road, and we'll document it a little bit later on, the struggle.
Me.
And look at Dave over here.
On second down and five. Kustak fakes it to Anderson and keeps it wide open. Cutting running room. 15, 10. And he's just shy of a 5-yard line before Ashante Woodyard.
Pitch guy Kustak able to come up field. Huge play for the Wildcats.
Kustak came in third in passing and total offense in the Big Ten. And he's adding to his numbers here. Now he steps up under center, changing the play. Their game plan is far from etched in stone, at least offensively. They make a number of changes on the field split second. Kustak will hand it off to Damian Anderson. And he's brought down at the 2-yard line. Simply unbelievable. Northwestern, perfect when you're talking about points inside the red zone.
And that number is unbelievable.
Anderson to the goal line, second and third after he won't get in. Again, brought down by Sean Phillips.
Now, interestingly enough, Steve, one of the things that you need to do here is that they decide to go with their power package and go with the I formation. They're running just fine without it. When you spread everybody, Kustak is able to fool people in the secondary, deliver the ball once again on the money.
That's Patrick's third reception of the game. Here's Anderson. And he's brought down at the 2. Possessions for each team prior to this series. 3 touchdowns and Purdue turning it over on downs. Kustak firing, able to complete, should be enough for the first down. Able to hook up with John Schweigert for his first reception of the afternoon.
And that's a big play.
Zach Kustak kicks it out, has to step up, pressure, and he's sacked. He's lucky to hang on to the football. Sean Phillips came with a bull rush and took Kustak down.
Steve, this is what happens when at 3rd and 20, you know that you have no run fake. There's no deception. You drop back to pass. Here's Adele at the bottom, but Phillips on the top, able to make an over move, just gets right past Mike Souza, the tackle, for the sack. Phillips be particularly happy with this, but give Kurtz credit for the heads up of just kicking the ball downfield and at least giving Purdue better field position.
Kurtz really, again, installed as the punter just 1 week ago. They only had one chance to do it last week.
Well, the problems continue for the punting unit with Purdue.
But the sound of the kicking game, somebody told me last time. Here's Damian Anderson. He's down to the 40-yard line. First and 10 after the Anderson run. He stopped a fake it to Anderson. Now keeps it and pitches out. Tricky play there as he's able to pitch out the
Stewart.
Give Kurtz credit here in this situation, Steve. At least he was able to get it off.
Anderson carries across mid, kicking and the punting. George trying to handle both. Kicked the game-winning field goal a week, of course. After missing an opportunity. Is tackled there just beyond midfield.
Big Terrell offensive tackle. Another tackle for loss for Purdue. I know
44 away from that here. Zach Kustak under pressure, and he'll go down. Kustak is dropped to the 18-yard line by Joe Odom, who's been second and 30. What do you pull out of the old playbook here? Here's Kustak under pressure. It's going to be worse than second and 30 now. Another sack.
Sean Phillips,
and it's Sean Phillips on the sack.
Two sacks and a tackle for loss. Guy's got about a half dozen tackles as well. Sean Phillips having himself a day. Came up the field. He gets a good job. Oh, just stuffs the left tackle. Oh, that's a great job. Great pass rush.
And they're starting to get the Kustak. This time he's keeping it himself. Damian Anderson, rather, off the fake. Second down and 15. Kustak on the fake. Damian Anderson up the middle to the 36-yard line. And now we'll get a timeout. It looks like Purdue has called the timeout.
Back to it. Once again, Purdue's going to have to come up with another third down conversion as we take a look at the numbers. Total yards. The one that stands out to me is right here. The total yards by Northwestern. We pointed out those first two drives. They're unbelievable since that time. Four straight punts.
Purdue with four sacks in that first half, getting to Zach Kustak. And a rare injury position of the second half. Northwestern will get another crack at it. With the momentum, with the break. Let's see what they do with it. Kustak out of the shotgun, running for his life. Johnson, and it's intercepted.
Is it
Ralph Turner?
I think it is, Steve.
At the Northwestern 47-yard line.
It is Ralph Turner. The ricochet goes right to him. How strange is that back-to-back have those sorts of turnovers? Kustak, we had talked about his the great job that he had at accuracy. This isn't that difficult to throw. He goes out, and really, in that situation, if Roger Jordan doesn't stick his hand out, it's incomplete. Instead, it ricochets off his hand, bounces right to the strong.
Northwestern needs a drive. They need something positive on offense. Here's Zach Kustak under pressure, throwing in for loose football, and Purdue says they have it. And the officials agree.
It appears that it's Randy Gardner is the one who comes up with the ball. It is number 16, converted wide receiver. He came to Purdue as a wide receiver, Steve. Started the season a middle linebacker. Now he's on the outside. Terrible time for Northwestern. Gilbert Gardner, rather, excuse me.
The true freshman coming up with the loose ball.
Now watch the lick at the point of attack. It wasn't such a traumatic lick, but again, give Gardner credit. Johnny on the spot, and a back-to-back turnovers for Northwestern, exactly what they didn't need here, Steve.
Will take over. What has happened to the Northwestern offense that scored touchdowns on their first two drives of the afternoon? Well, some of that, I have to give credit to the Purdue defense.
You certainly do, because coming in here, Steve, everybody was talking about it was the University of Purdue. But the reality is he can score all the points he wants. If the defense doesn't stop people, he doesn't get his opportunities. You can see there, with the exception of Ohio State, you could argue that Purdue is the best defense in the Big Ten.
Kustak fakes it to Anderson, now fires, and it's Kool-Aid Patrick, who fumbled the football after his left. His wife wanted us to say hi. His wife, of course, graduated from Purdue, so every year they celebrate this day in Purdue and Northwestern. And that pass is intercepted.
Steve, I think it might have been Aiken Adele who stepped back into coverage. It was number 13. Normally the defensive end and a pass rusher steps back into coverage, and Kustak just flat out did not see him.
Well, that way, Mary Karski's happy, but not Jim Karski's. Jim, we're thinking about you.
Right in the chest for Adele. Kustak does not see him. We talked about the fact that number 13 had put up some big numbers last year. Up to this point, unable to do that. He comes back into coverage. You see him right in the middle. He comes from his defensive end position and backpedals to the 4-yard line and comes up with the pick.
Kustak on the move, able to get to Roger Jordan, cuts it upfield to the 36-yard line. Goalposts are being torn down at an alarming rate across the country.
I'm guessing that he's going to have a boost, though. I think Lou Holtz is about 5'8" and, what, 130 pounds? Somebody's going to have to help him.
He's got the vertical.
Last second.
But another crack for Danielson and Northwestern.
Run the same play.
Good for him. This is his chance to get it running. Across the middle, pass is complete. To Lewis Ianni. He stopped well shy of the goal line, but Danielson does have a perfect day outside. Oh, in fact, his team lost the game.